This is Circa from Mobile Divide. I'll be comparing three devices today. The first one is the BlackBerry Bold from RIM. My number one feature that I love is BBM, BlackBerry messaging. If you haven't used it, you need to use it and check it out. It's virtually instantaneous SMSing with anyone in the world, unlimited, but they have to have a BlackBerry. My number one con is Big Brother. This is the ultimate Big Brother device in my opinion. I feel like I'm being watched and monitored all the time. Apps appear, apps disappear, features are there, features aren't there. Settings are there, settings aren't there. What's going on with the BlackBerry Bold? That's the first one. Second one is the iPhone. There's the iPhone. My favorite feature is the App Store. It is a dream come true in my opinion. More devices and vendors need to take a look at this and copy it if they can. App Store rules, coming from Nokia and some other devices, this is the one to beat. App Store rules. Number two, I don't like the fact that the App Store is limited, okay? So that's my favorite feature, but it's also my con. The App Store is limited because Apple is playing Big Brother. Granted, not as much as RIM, but they still are. You can't run apps in the background. Still, there's still no copy and paste. Thanks, that's the iPhone. And here is the Nokia N95. This is my workhorse. This is my good friend, okay? So this is the N95 8 gig. Number one feature, this device is open to anything, okay? Anything. Apps, the fact that you can communicate with other phones over Bluetooth, it comes unlocked, unbranded from Nokia. I really love that. That's an important feature, especially for users in the US that aren't still familiar with this device. You need to check it out. Nokia's doing a great job with that. My number one con with this device, though, is the fact that the App Store, there's still no App Store. I know people love the fact that, you know, you can put whatever app on there and it's all over the internet, it's all over the place, but if you're not a geek, you're not getting apps on this thing. Trust me, I know people that have this phone that use it for texting and for voice, and that's it. And that's a real shame. Nokia needs to lead again with this in this area. I think they can do it and they should do it. Okay, and we would have loved to review the Android phone, but unfortunately, T-Mobile has not sent us a G1. We will review it, T-Mobile, send us a G1. It's up to you. That's about it for now. Keep tuning back for more at mobiledivide.com.